It's Den, and it's 3 a.m., and I'm back with another coloring for you video, where I color very late at night, and you relax and maybe drift off to sleep. And if you're not trying to fall asleep, maybe you can color along with me. Okay, so this is Cthulhu. This is my new Cthulhu coloring book. I'm so jazzed. I got in the mail yesterday, along with this hardback Cthulhu book, which is beautiful, and I'm going to show it off sometime, maybe in another video. It's just full of art and pictures and information about H.P. Lovecraft. It's awesome and wonderful, amazing, and the coloring book is really neat, too. I'm so excited. So, let's get started. And since I am honoring H.P. Lovecraft, I'll read a quote from him, from The Outsider. I love that story. Okay, here goes. I know always that I am an outsider, a stranger in this century, and among those who are still men. Again, that's the short story of The Outsider. I love that one. Well, I love most of them. Okay, let's see. Let's get started, I guess. I'll try not to talk too loud or make really harsh noises. As usual, I'm working at the facility and my dogs are here with me. So if you hear strange noises, it's probably Daisy snoring because she snores. She snores like a little freight train. H.P. Lovecraft. Love him. Adore him. He's amazing. I'm absolutely under his spell. And I love Cthulhu, too. Awesome and amazing. So fantastical. Asleep, I can't stay asleep. That used to be my big problem. I could fall asleep rather easily, but I'd wake up about 2 hours later, start overthinking things. I thought I was helping myself by just kind of letting my mind wander, but pretty soon I was thinking about things that have happened 20 years ago, 30 years ago. And I would start getting anxious, and then later I realized 3 hours had passed, and I'm not asleep. So, that's one of the ways I've dealt with my chronic sleeplessness, is working the night shift, the graveyard shift. She's gonna go back to sleep. So this is my fourth coloring for you video. Slowly. And the time passes really quickly when I do it. I was talking last week about how every time I start one of these videos, I have a strange song stuck in my head. Something I don't normally listen to and don't know how it got there. Let's see, last week it was Heard It Through the Grapevine. It's not that I don't like it, I just don't listen to it. I don't know where I even heard it in a very, very long time. It's stuck in my head for days. Finally went away, but now there's another song that's taking its place. Same kind of thing. I don't know where I've heard it. I mean, it's Aerosmith. Don't want to miss a thing. I don't really care for it that much. I know it's a pretty song, I suppose. I kind of prefer the older, harder Aerosmith. But, like I'm saying, I don't even know where I heard it to get stuck in my head. I don't think I've really heard it since like the late 80s, early 90s, whenever it was popular. What was it called? Don't Want to Miss a Thing, you know, that slow romantic song. It's just not really my thing. So now that's in my head. Who knows why? About it just made it worse. No, it's really playing around in my head. I noticed that I never get songs stuck in my head that I love. Ever. I don't know why that is. Cthulhu. A monster of vaguely arthropod outline, but with an octopus-like head, whose face was a mass of feelers, a scaly, rubbery-looking body, prodigious claws on hind and fore feet, and long, narrow wings behind. Sorry, I butchered that. I was not prepared for the word prodigious. Prodigious. Yes, HP got me good. Prodigious. That was a good secret. Yeah, this is not good. This is not good. I don't know that I have any other block either. Of course I don't. Get away with making them purple. I mean, you know, what are you gonna do? You're gonna improvise, right? Because this is broken. See? No good. I'll try to sharpen it, but I don't have the hopes for it. This may be my only talent. Coloring upside down. Snort, and then I recorded myself a couple times when I slept, because I was kind of getting them weird stuff, EVPs, who knows. What I didn't expect was to hear myself snoring. It was so embarrassing. I do snore. It's terrible. This block, because it's really light. I'm definitely gonna get another better black pencil, I think. That's not uncommon here. I have to watch the security cam. Just in case. Thank you. have several favorite ones. I love all the dream cycle stories. Hypnosis. In the walls, a Pickman's model. See the nameless city. It's good. Obviously Call of Cthulhu. Big one. Some of the longer ones, like the Dunwich Horror, the Dreams in a Witch House. I really love his short stories. Ship. Oh, the white ship. Yes. things all up from memory. And my mind is kind of blank. Favorite ones aren't coming to my head. But yeah, I love the White Ship, Hypnos, I love the Tip. Thank you. sense of madness. See, I have gone mad. Yes, at the mountains of madness. To be fair, I was trying to name the shorter ones. That one's quite long. Doorstep is the story with Dan Upton and his friend, I don't remember his name, he's possessed by his wife. In a cave. Now, I don't know why, but that one doesn't seem like it's HPs. I mean, I know it is, I guess. It just doesn't seem like, I don't know, I've always, I don't know why, I can't explain it. It just doesn't fit for some reason. I don't know what I'm talking about. I just feel like somebody else read it. Say he did. He wouldn't say that, but someone else is trying to say possibly that was his. I don't know. What do I know? It just doesn't seem like it's not that it's not good, or that's all I'm saying.
I just don't.
I don't feel like it belongs. Beast in a cave. Crazy about H.P. Lovecraft, but I'm not an expert by far. Believe it or not, I always knew about Lovecraft, or wasn't really into any of it until about a year and a half or more ago. A year and a half or so. And all of a sudden it just clicked, you know. I was listening to a couple people that read Lovecraft on YouTube, and it clicked, and I fell in love. Finally. Because I love horror, you know, and he really is like horror. So many. He's awesome-tasticness. Awesome-tasticness. He's spectacular. I can't remember what they're called, but he's got those, the stories about the weird fungus people. They're like human, part human, part fungus. Really weird and strange. And of course, you know, all the stories of the great old ones. Statement Randolph called Carter. I'm not sure. I should probably set up somewhere to be. But I'm not going to. Let's see. I fishes. The little piranha serpents. Fucking up the whole thing. Well, I can't use that one right now. It's all shit. It's all going to shit. Oh no. Okay. Well, what are you gonna do? Just kind of. I don't really want to do that. Listen, pencil. You cannot betray me this way. Okay? You're ruining my picture, making it look stupid. Okay, this has been over an hour long, and everything's going to hell. Let's see what I'm gonna do. I'm losing it. I'm losing it. Okay. Sorry, I don't know what's wrong with me. Oh God. What are these? These right here. I'm sorry, I don't know what they are though. It's like, what the fuck? What the fuck? You beautiful beast. I don't know what these are. Okay, I just realized how long this video is, and freaking me out a little bit. Plus, I am supposed to be working. The world's slowest color. I don't know, I'm just very slow when I color. Hopefully you're asleep and don't realize how much nonsense I've been babbling off and making a complete ass out of myself, because I don't really edit these and at all, because I don't know how. I just record them on my phone. I'm not supposed to be doing that at work. So I just upload them. Raw and ridiculous. Boy. Thank you. tell what's what right here. So Dyer comes in and I'm coloring, I'm gonna be in some deep shit. Okay. I always think it's gonna take about an hour. It doesn't take so long. Okay. Oh, mighty Cthulhu. I am going to... of it. Wait. I think so that it doesn't, you know. Well, I don't want to make this another hour long, and I don't want to lose what's going on here. So, this pillar is white. In Relia, as the pillars of Relia there. Well, that cyclopean, non-Euclidean stuff going on down there in Relia, you know. Cyclopean architecture and non-Euclidean geometry. And Relia. upside down, too. I'm looking at non-Euclidean geometry and cyclopean architecture in the sunken place of the great Cthulhu, where he is sleeping and dreaming and dreaming and sleeping. And it's confusing. Even more non-Euclidean and even more cyclopean. It's upside down, real life. It's supposed to be like that because, you know, you expect. Cyclopean architecture. Can I shut up now? The fuck I'm talking about. I'm gonna make Cthulhu mad. I don't wanna do that. I don't want him to be mad at me. Hey, great old dude. This video was long, much longer than I intended. I hope it was relaxing and sleep-inducing. So I am going to end it now. Thank you for joining me. It's been fun and neat. And I hope it helps you or entertains you or something. Or maybe you colored along with me. I will be back next week with another coloring for you video. Okay, that's it. Ow, sorry. Done out.